Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist preaching gospel. So gospel is as it is as ABC, if you can think logically. People who go to the universities and colleges, they can't think logically. They go by the book. What this man has written, that man has written. But they can't think logically. What is written is correct or not. So unless you are living in Holy Spirit, which is common sense, you cannot have gospel. So that's why when the good news was given of the birth of Jesus, the Christ, it was given to the shepherds in the field, illiterate people, and not to the Jerusalem theologians, where Maggie went there to test them, how much they honored him. They did not honor him, so Maggie did not go back, because Herod and those temple priests, they are colluded with each other to kill Jesus. So you can see how much love they have for Jesus. And here it is shown in Gospel of Matthew 11, verse 20 to 24. Here Jesus showed how much they appreciated the services he rendered to the people in curing their sick and all that, you know. But Jesus said, I have come to cure the chosen people and not the Gentile. I've been sent to the chosen people. And that's what they did to him. He was devoted to them and how they reacted to it. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., given by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his temple of God. This is the temple of God, created by the greatest artist, demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, is same thing. And it is called Harmandir. Har means God, Mandir means temple, his temple, or Emmanuel. God is with us, according to Saint Matthew 11, verse 22-24. Jesus began to reproach the towns where most of his mighty deeds had been done, since they had not repented or joined Christ Jesus to preach gospel, but they kept on sticking to their temple priest, and they turned their back to Jesus after he had done so good things. They turned their back to Jesus and they turned back to Joseph when he looked after them in the wilderness. When they were in the exile in Egypt, he looked after them, got them the best land and everything. But when they returned back to the promised land, faithful sons of Abraham and of Yahweh, they still hated them. The generation of Joseph is called Samaritans. Samaritans are salt of the earth. They are faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, and they appreciated gospel. Remember when in John 4, even the woman, Samaritan woman, was so well versed in the gospel that she wetted Jesus in Holy Spirit and proclaimed that you are a prophet. she told Jesus that when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. So she knew the difference between Jesus, a prophet, and a Christ. So here is the difference between the two. So bear with me. So here is the John the Baptist, moon, a witness to the light, but not the light. So prophets deal with the skin here, which is the moon. Moonlight applied here, which is full of Sharia. Moon is bound, is not a free. Here is sun, the primary source of light. Without this, moon is useless. Without soul from our supernatural father, this body is useless. So here is the prophet. John the Baptist. They are also called angels. And here is Christ Jesus and his brethren, sons of the Most High Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. This is the Allah Parbrahm, the father of our souls. So John the Baptist was a prophet. He was the cornerstone of the temple. He was pushed out by the hypocrite temple priest. And remember, they killed a prophet in the temple, Zechariah. And also, they hated the nation of prophets, Samaritans. So the light came among the chosen people, because they needed light. Among the chosen people, and the chosen people, they hated Jesus the most. And remember that these chosen people have special place in our society. They are the nation of Abram. He was picked up from Iraq area by Yahweh and promised a land in the Middle East. So Abram with his wife and cattle and all those, he left it, kith and kin, and came to settle in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve. And the promised land was given to them at the Garden of Eden. So far they were faithful to Abram, faithful to Yahweh. Their crops were plentiful. As soon as they become unfaithful to Abram, unfaithful to Yahweh, the same land became barren. Jacob had 12 sons. Out of the 12, 11 were crook. They wanted to kill Joseph, honest person. As soon as Joseph, the salt of the earth, faithful to Abram, faithful to Yahweh, left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Abram or to Yahweh. So Abraham is the father of the faithful and not of the unfaithful people. So he kicked them out of the promised land, that there was no, Yahweh did not give them rain. So Yahweh and Abraham, they both kicked them out of the promised land. And they went to Egypt as a slave and they were suffering. This story has been told by Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son, where the elder one is Ishmael, the Egyptian, who were feeding. They were not suffering any famine or anything, living comfortably. and they were given the morality, conscience. And here were the people of Itek who were given the spirituality. But they became so arrogant that they start hating other people. So when you hate the other people, you are arrogant. You can't enter into the royal kingdom of God, which has narrow gate. So they could not enter, and they did not like people to be entering either. So here is the our royal kingdom of God, into which Jesus took his laborers to work. John the Baptist had the scripture, law and prophets are till John the Baptist. Luke 16 verse 16. And after that no law and no law, no sin, and no law and order. So Jesus created 70 outer circle laborers in honor of John the Baptist. But these Jewish people, you know, they pulled them down. They bring in their own temple practices. And they made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. So those people who came to John the Baptist, they were the Jewish people who came, not a Gentile. Gentiles were already faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. So Jewish people who were unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, the saltless people, sorry for my cough. So saltless people, they were dominating the temple. And that's why when Jesus told them in the temple that if you are faithful sons of Abraham, then you would have loved to listen to me. But you are not, you are saltless people. Because they had become Jew outwardly. When they become Jew outwardly, they can't build their covenant with Abraham. This their father in the church called Oregon, he tried to build the covenant of Jews with Abraham. That man did not know that Jew is a spiritual self, not a physical self. So he said he can't build it, he can go up to Jacob, but not further. So such was the darkness at that time. And people of the book, they were dominating. Those with the Holy Spirit of common sense, when they realize that when they become Jew outwardly, they break their covenant with their tribal father. And also with Abraham, they become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, saltless people, and the temple priests were. So when Jesus told in the temple that he is the Messiah, the son of Elohim, they took stones to kill him. Same thing among the Samaritan woman. When Jesus told her, when she said that you are a prophet, and when Christ come, he will tell us everything. When Jesus told her that he is the Christ, then she was so happy because she found no difficulty in recognizing Christ. She was salt, people of salt, salt of the earth. So she went to her village and told everyone, I have found him. But Christ, you have to vet it yourself. Nobody can tell you that he is the Christ. You have to vet it yourself. So that's why she said, go and vet him yourself. Don't trust me. In Jesus, whether you are a man or a woman, we are equal. Because our soul is concerned. So here you are, this is the John the Baptist baptizing in water in the name of Abraham. He baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. Yes from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam, or Mary was sired by Yahweh, not by any man, tribal man. Yahweh, the greatest artist. So he wants to be born among the people of Judah tribe, and that's why Mary was of Judah tribe. So Mary was foster and surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father. So he came floating, and floating he went. He left no mark on the earth, because the foxes have holes to rest their head. But the Son of Man, being the second Adam, he had nothing on this earth that belonged to him. So he took away his body, away everything. So here you are. Those people who realize they were twice born, they came to John the Baptist, most of them. They have the Holy Spirit. But when Jesus came to be baptized, Holy Spirit rested over his head and the heaven opened up. That means our Father is above heaven, above nature, because he's a supernatural, he's not natural. The voice came that this is my loving Son. Listen to him. So our Father is no more in heaven, but he is in here, which is supernatural, in a temple created by Yahweh, the greatest artist. So those people, then being Son of Man, tribal fathers, faithful to Abraham, they bury the ego of their tribal self in the soil, turn it into plant. That becomes twice born. Because in God, there is neither Jew, not Gentile, not man or a woman. We are all sons of the Most High, because our soul is concerned, not the flesh. So here, if you enter, you and your wife, you are brethren, and not husband and wife. So all these relations are here, and here you become solitary, and everyone is solitary. That's why Jesus said, unless you leave your mother, father, and everything to enter this narrow gate, become solitary, capable of entering this narrow gate to become sadhus like Melchizedek, who only sing the praises of our supernatural Father. Then you can graft yourself to the true vine and sing the praises of our supernatural Father, Elohim Allah Parbrahm. So you can see that children people have a strong instinct that they belong to Abraham. Forefather is Abraham, who is a noble man. And that's why Angel Stephen told them in the temple, our forefather Abraham is a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the seed of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. But they were circumcising Gentile and slaves and all those people to increase the number of their disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. So the rabbis, they had disciples. Not in Jesus, we are here, we are all brethren, twice born, no disciple. Disciple is a slave. Here we are not slave. We are set free by Jesus. Jesus does not enslave us. He does not tell us that, do what I tell you to do, as the rabbi will tell. So no enforcement over here, no law. Holy Spirit, we are all set free here. I hope I have given you enough introduction now, and now you will understand why people, where Jesus performed such mighty deeds, they did not appreciate him, and they were still linked to the Jerusalem temple, the high priest. Remember that man in Gennesaret, where Jesus drowned 2,000 swine. That priest also had stooges. They were all sticking to the temple. Only these two people, they listened to Christ Jesus, and they became solitary, and they joined hands with Jesus and were preaching gospel at the roadside and everywhere, wherever they could find, because they were not allowed to enter a synagogue. The rabbi would let them in, because over there he was propagating what the temple was propagating, making them Jew outwardly. So that's why they were putting heavy chains around them, locking them in the silence of the graveyard. But what God has set free, no man can bind him. Remember how Paul and Silas, after being beaten, they were put in so they were put in a jail among the other prisoners. In the prison they sang the praises of our Supernatural Father, and those prisoners which have no attraction for mammon, not seeking the praises of men, they were solitary. We listened to them and their chains fell off, and all their walls fell off. They were totally set free. Whereas those people in the town where the mammon money was concerned, when he said you can't make statue this and that, over there, they were in business in mammon. They hated St. Paul and Silas. Today you have St. Paul's Cathedral in London, and I asked them, where is St. Paul statue? Hey, it's on the top of the pinnacle. That means on the top of the roof. When St. Paul come and see his own statue on the top of the roof, how happy he would be. So this is the Christianity, British Christianity. And St. Paul Cathedral is full of the soldiers who killed people, generals, viceroys, and other soldiers. Their priests will tell them they glorify God. Whereas salvation of people, men of, who exercise agape, they say their soldier died for king and country, which is gospel truth. There is the gospel truth in Britain. But the Church of England people, they are dominant, like those the temple priests had, dominant stooges. So that is why there is so much corruption. These obersmen and other people, they are racist. And no justice can be got from them. I have about 10 cases. Every case I took to Obersman, there was no justice. I was defeated. If anybody is interested, I can present him the case, and he can see himself how racist the British are. So they take the black man because they ruled over them as if they have no brain. They take us for a donkey. And that is how their mentality is even today. And such was the mentality of the Jewish people in the temple. Anybody who goes against the temple practices, they were thinking he was a stupid man, leaving the broad road and following the narrow road. So I hope I've given you enough of this material, and this is the one which is very important, how the Jewish people, they bring bloodshed in all these countries, starting with Iraq, the homeland of Abraham. How can you trust people to kill their own forefather Abraham and his people in Iraq, noble people? And there were no weapons of mass destruction found by a major general. And those two blasphemers, Tony Blair and Bush, they destroyed one country after the other under the excuse of this and that, lame excuses. And people of conscience in Christ Jesus, please wake up and let's raise voice against injustices and hypocrisies. So, here is a relationship under Adam. You have races, under races you have tribes. There is no Jew here. Because Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual, not physical. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. But people of Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, so and so, led by the blind guides, they died. And today we are super blind people. So here is John the Baptist, which was to the light angel. He was not a saint, John the Baptist, he was angel. And here we are saint, the 12 inner circle laborers. The 12 inner circle laborers have nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. I have put an article on that one. There were 7 in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ Jesus. So I can carry on here with this thing. It's so interesting, very interesting, because this chosen people, they are demonstration nation of the world. Through them we learn all the moral laws. So we should appreciate their sacrifices under their blind guides, warning us not to follow anyone. Blind people follow others. I'm not a follower of Jesus because I'm not a blind. I join hands with him. I'm solitary, Jesus is solitary. That's why Jesus, when he feed the 5,000, he told his laborer, do you also want to leave? They said, no, we are with you. So they were all given freedom to leave. They were all solitary. So Jesus began to reproach the towns where most of his mighty deeds have been done, since they had not repented. Not repented means come into the royal kingdom of God, which is above. So, they not repent. This is our repentance, baptism or repentance. And those who repented and became the sons of the faithful sons of Abraham, salt of the earth, they buried their tribal seed to turn into plant. And through this fire, bush fire, where your ego is burnt. Ego was burnt here. And then you become twice born. Here your soul is concerned and not your physical body. You are neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile. That is why St. James the Just was telling them that in Christ Jesus in God, we are all one, whether you are Jew or Gentile. And he told the rabbis, they were not happy. They understood him, what he said, message. But they told him, next Passover, you go on the pinnacle and give the same sermon to everyone. He said, oh, that's a good idea. So clever people, they put him on the, told him, oh, go ahead, say, give the just, and tell everybody from the pinnacle. When he told them that in God, we are all equal. Don't hate anyone, don't cheat anyone. And those rabbis told them, their stooges, hey, look, he's making us equal to Gentile. So they went up and threw him down, and then they killed him with a fuller staff. So that is the type of people over there in the temple world. And Jesus was handed over to them, or Jesus himself handed himself to them to be crucified as the Lamb of God. So today they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning, which is expected or when Israel is 75 years old. So the Israel was 70 years old in 2018. Now the AD does not start from the birth of Jesus, but when he was in his seventh year. The seventh year is this one of menorah. The seventh year is this middle candle of menorah. So the sixth hour of the Yahweh. So these six are of Yahweh are works. Works are social, ecumenical, and political affairs. Some are holy, some are evil. David's cross, upside down, two triangles. These works lead to reincarnation. It is becoming the Son of the Most High, this one, middle candle, which is of Elohim. All the other candles are lit from this middle candle. And Christ is the Son of Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. So he is supernatural. Our soul is supernatural. Soul comes from this one. Without soul, the body is dead. Thoughts are dead. So that's why John the Baptist, he was Lord of the nature. My God is Yahweh, Lord of the nature. And the Lord of the, our supernatural Father, he is the Lord of nature. What people are, he's Lord of them. So John the Baptist, Prophet Elijah, is Lord of the physical body. That is where the water comes in, washing in water. The soul comes from our supernatural Father, and he is the Lord over the Lord, Yahweh, on the people. So that's why Jesus said, I am the Lord of the Sabbath. But he is our brother, anointed elder brother. Because in God we have one Father. And in the royal kingdom of God, we have one Father. And so he is our anointed elder brother, or our bridegroom. And we are the virgin brides. And not married. Although we are married, we are still virgin bride. The marriage of the Christ Jesus was Eucharist, Last Supper, when he washed the feet of the 11. The crook, Judas Iscariot, was thrown out because he was a thief, stealing money from the church purse, as the dog people do today. So he was thrown out before he started his baptism, which is Eucharist. And he baptized the 11 in Holy Spirit, in the name of Father and Holy Spirit. Father, our Son, our Father, God, and Holy Spirit is our Mother, spiritual Mother, the wisdom, highest wisdom. So much more we can tell, because I come from India, Punjab, where the second coming of Jesus took place, and over there the God himself came in the name of Govindrai and his escort, the one he married, third wife. He had no intercourse with her. She was virgin. And that is Holy Spirit. And she was the mother of the Khalsas and also the Nirmala Santas, our apostles. So much more you can learn through Sikhism as well. So that's why I have mastery over these things. Jesus cured 10 lepers, 9 the saltless Jews outwardly, unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, and 1 Samaritan of salt of the earth, faithful to Abraham and faithful to Yahweh. So he appreciated what Jesus has done to him. So those people, you know, the one saltless people, they did not appreciate Jesus. As soon as they were cured, they want to run back to the synagogue and sit in the synagogue and tell the priest, "Hey, I'm cured now." And they were with stiff neck, they were sitting in the synagogue and not bothering to uplift them to the royal kingdom of God, which is above the synagogues. So they did not appreciate what Jesus did to them. They did not do what Jesus wanted them to have become solitary like him and join hands with him. So those people, they are saltless people, and that is how they behave. They can't say thank you even. But when they want to be cured, they were humble. So Samaritan, being salt of the earth, he returned back and to thank Jesus and wanted to join him. But Jesus told him, No, your rabbis, they are very efficient. You don't need Christ. So he was sent back to his family. And when Jesus went there, if you remember the parable of tenants, one was given 5 talents. Those who were given 5 talents, they were the Samaritan people. And one was given 2, they were the temple priests, clever people who squandered 5, who squandered the 2. And they were in debt after that one. They did not make 4 or 5 or anything. The one who was given 1, they were people of the book, as the university professors are today. So they read the book, Bible, by heart, and that is their gospel. They don't know the gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart, because it is the taproot of the tree of life. And here is the tree of life. The tree of life. So this is a scripture here, tree. Now the top root of this tree is oral Torah. Oral Torah is his word, which Jesus came to deliver. and they hated him. So that's why Jesus is reproaching them. If you have this knowledge, then your scripture tree will be green, not dead. So Samaritan tree, it was green, and the same with the Gentile, they are green. That's why Saint Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die, as the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. And in India, you know, we have a good respect for the Arabian people, who were known that they were poor, living in the desert, and they were very hospitable in the name of Abraham. But when they got this black gold, oh, they turned it around. They have become the cruel people. So they are no more those Bandhu, we used to call them, but they are cruel people, clever people, and mullahs from Kashmir, the epicenter of Satan, they have become over there dominant, and they are creating all this problem, and you will see how they suffer. So the other nine even don't say thank you to Jesus. That is the nature of the saltless people, as demonstrated in the destruction of Iraq, homeland of their forefather Abraham, a noble man. The homeland of Abram, a noble man, that established Israel, the Garden of Eden. Faithful sons of Abraham. Woe to you, Chorazin. Chorazin. Woe to you, Bethsaida. For if the mighty deeds done in you, your midst, had been done in Tyre and Sidon, which they think they were thinking that those people, because they don't go to synagogue and all that, they were once upon people, illiterate people, looking after the sheep and all that, not educated. They would have appreciated much more, but they were educated, this one, in the synagogue, like the temple priest in the Jerusalem, and they hated Jesus. They would long ago have repented in sackcloth and ashes. So that is the repentance they have, should have, you know, that they should be, when they are twice born, they should bury the ego of their flesh, tribal ego. Jesus wanted to save them from the clutches of the most powerful sons of Satan, Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, the temple priest. But they love the high, they love the highly sugar-coated sermons of those sons of Satan. You know, the sugar-coated sermon, they are dominant today. Politicians, when they want to be elected, they give you sugar-coated sermons and make you to vote for them. Much more in this one, which I can't tell in this lecture. The people, they were hating, for they were ignorant of law, village people. Village people, they hated them, as they, when Nicodemus told them the Messiah is coming from Nazareth, the temple priest was saying, hey, they are not educated. How can Messiah come from there? So educated people, Magi did not return to them. She went to see the shepherds, and after shepherds, she went back to India. The people they were hating, or they were ignorant of law, village people, that means they were not educated. They did not go to any university or anything. They were like shepherds to whom the good news was broken. And as for you, Capernaum, you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven, where people live in law and order? They were studying, you know, books, Torah and all that. So they were, if they obey those laws, laws are good if they obey them in spirit. But they were not. They were just reading, as you have in the course, people reading the law, but not applying it in spirit, not using common sense. And people suffered. So, you will go down to the netherworld, the hell in looting and cheating people, those who are educated, and that is where they go. I lived in Ghana, West Africa, where the chief, they are the judge. If any dispute between brethren over there, first of all, they, in 14 years we lived there, we only see once people fighting, and that was only a minor one, you know, over land, that this land belonged to me and other. But it was soon settled among them, and they soon were shaking hands and everything. So hardly anyone did it. They live like brethren, although they belong to different tribes. And if you give one of them something to eat, he won't eat himself. He will call everyone, come and share with me. So all share with him. That is communism. And that is what Jesus brings into this world. Not capitalist society where one is rich and the other one is poor. Samaritan society of communist. That's why in netherworld, the hell in looting and cheating, that's where the law and these books lead you. America is a hell, even Britain is a hell. Small thing, you don't get justice. And if you want to fight for justice, oh, you can sell your own house, and still you are not sure if you will get justice. So justice has taken with the wing, gone away. And all this is hypocrisy. For if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Sodom, Sodom is the town known for sinners. Sinners. That's why they are Sodom and Gomorrah. Sinners. That's why they Jesus said if we are done among those sinner people who wanted to kill people or have no friends. The great sinners, it would have remained until this day. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom on the day of judgment than for you whom the taproot of the tree of life, the oral Torah or his word. Matthew 13 verse 52 describe an ideal rabbi was delivered. So hope it makes sense. It is very interesting, but the gospel is, you get it by the grace of our supernatural Father, and nobody can give you these books you have. It is written, but they could be twisted. So in Jesus we don't have disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. In the rabbis, they discipline their intake natural boys by teaching them the moral of Moses. And they have the disciple, not Jesus. In Jesus, we are laborers and workers who are twice born, not once born. So many corruptions are there. But these people in the universities, they are men of dead letters. They have no understanding. I asked them that John the Baptist said, I baptize you in water. The one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. You don't see them in the churches. You see them baptizing women and other people, Gentile, in the name of Father, Son and Holy Spirit, which is not what John the Baptist did. And he said, after me will do it. So, in whose name then John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water? They have no idea. Although it is written in the Bible, don't you say that you are sons of Abraham? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. Stone means simple-minded people, which the clever people of the Jerusalem call them Gushi Kopa. Gushi Kopa. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love, because we hate none. Everyone has the soul of our supernatural Father. Everyone is our brother. So we have no enemy or stranger. All our brethren in agape, God blesses you.